Hey, sup cool, here's We Nerd. Get your bowls, your bongs, your pipes, your big fat joints, your hookahs, your blunts. We got a little Jimmy along the watchtower. Live from the studio soundboard.
There must be some kind of way out of here.
It's a little different.
Said I'm jumping to the lead. There's too much confusion.
We got a couple things to talk about today. I think mostly we're just going to goof around. So that's always fun too, isn't it? I got to show y'all a couple different tunes here. We're going to have some fun with some music. Let's fire up a little 120 UI space bomb. Man, that was nice. We're going to jump right into the show today. I got lots of stuff to talk about. I'm going to grab something a little B-side. Fire you guys up. Well, it's time for us to do a little fun here today. So we've just finished doing some work. And we're going to do some special trying out. Our good friends at Buzz and Roses have sent us the cup-winning sample.
That's correct.
Of the Girl Scout cookies. And since Miss Jill is the flower smoker in the house, we got the bong all fired up with a brand new. Check out this bowl. It looked like nothing when we bought it. But then as we start smoking out of it, old Bob Snodgrass and his fuming, Summits was a genius. It was a clear bowl when we started.
That's awesome.
It was just clear. It looked like it was nothing.
He's a madman.
So here's the Girl Scout cookies that won the cup. I'll leave my comments out of it because I'm not a big cookie fan. But for a sample, it smells amazing. So Miss Jill's going to chop it up for us and tell us what she thinks. Check on our crop today. Everything's looking fantastic. I'm actually starting to worry about the heat out here. I mean, it's 91 degrees, so that's probably 100 on the porch. It's not going to be too long before we get these off this deck. This deck's exceptionally hot. Look how beautiful these plants are. Just phenomenal. Happy topping. There's the one mutant we hadn't topped. I'll probably top him today. He was just a slow starter. He wasn't really a mutant. That looked really good. The dark green is because we've started using regular well water on them. Our well water's high in CalMag, but these plants are well rooted and they'll be fine. Strong, strong, strong. Oh, and that pink just blowing it up, isn't it? Okay, Miss Jill is now going to try the cup-winning Girl Scout cookies from Buds and Roses. Pretty big.
Is it grown in Kyle Cushman's vegan?
Looks like this is veganics.
Yep.
Okay.
Smooth.
Yeah, I thought it was really smooth.
Nice flavor.
Nice. Good flavor.
Yeah, absolutely. I think we'll go with another one of these.
That's what I was thinking you would do. Kind of give us your test on it. Let me get you loaded up again. Now this is Kyle Cushman's strawberry cough, and in her travels, Miss Jill picked up this little bitty bong. So this is just about my size. So I'm gonna try it out real quick. So, little Kyle Cushman's strawberry cough. Kyle, this one's for you, bro.
Time wreck. Looking pretty good. You'll be seeing lots of her today.
Okay, so I'm here with some strawberry cough grown in Veganics by Kyle Cushman. When I met Kyle and I got to smell his herbs and stuff, they smell so good, but I don't smoke a lot of herbs. So just for you, buddy. I'd like to give a shout out to Aaron at Buds and Roses. Thank you for all you do for TGA. Solid, man. Anything I can do for you, just let me know. It is smooth.
It's tasty.
Oh, it is very smooth. I get a little bit of strawberries.
Has a nice nose to it.
Well, good job, man. Thank you. Yeah. Awesome. Okay, Miss Jill's on cam now. She's going to do her second hit of Girl Scout cookies from Buds and Roses, grown by Kyle Cushman and Veganics. Jimmy in the background from live sessions.
Thanks, Kyle.
You must like that one.
I do.
Fucking awesome.
Great.
Good job. And this is what Joey's paws looks like when it blooms. Kind of a crazy green flower. Kangaroo plant. Okay, now T.C. Curtis is going to try out some of Dirk Diggler's very own Cotton Candy Kush.
Oh, excellent.
That's got a cool taste, doesn't it?
It's got the cotton candy.
Do you taste it? You surely taste it. I do.
Yeah. Good job, Dirk.
So that's it from the smoke sessions today. That don't mean we're going to quit smoking. We're just going to turn the cam off. See you later, guys.
See ya.
Little jam from Jimmy Call. Calling all the devil's children jam. So in news today from Toke of the Town, which I found out yesterday is no longer brought to you by Steve Elliott. This particular article is by William Breathes, and basically Colorado recreational marijuana appeal being considered by some legislators. And this is my question to those legislators. Do you walk outside of your fucking house? Have you been down Broadway Avenue? Marijuana's in Colorado, and it ain't leaving. I don't give a shit what you legislators decide in your little offices while you're taking your little pills, drinking your shots of single malt scotch. Weed's not going away. It's not going away in Colorado. It's not going away in California. It's not going away in Washington. It's not going away in Oregon. Weed is not going away. You can go to Florida where some of the stiffest penalties in the world are for smoking marijuana. They'll take your fucking van away or car away for a fucking roach. There's 20 head shops in the goddamn place. The war is over. Redirect the funds. Move them to other positions. Blows my fucking mind. Take out on some base, go look at some outdoor plants. I just got a new load of the white hats in for summertime. So I'm going to put more in for the Sons of Dang shirts in just a little bit. So that should be fun. While Jimmy gets revved up here, everybody have a puff of toke with me. I'm going to do some recording.
So now Miss Jill is going to try some Tokyo OG from Starfire Organics. Our friend Rosie. Hi, Rosie. We know she watches the Weed Nerd Show because she's told me to. So Miss Jill loves OGs. So we'll get it out, take a look at it, and then we'll smoke some. So this is the Tahoe OG from Starfire Organics, a high-end delivery service. They handle doctors and lawyers, and, you know, people that don't necessarily want to see dispensaries, and they only deal in top shelf bud. And they're known for having TGA flowers. Gotta love this cam light. Really helps illuminate the trichomes. So Miss Jill and TC Curtis are both gonna test this up for us.
Hi, well, I have to say that Kyle's cookies is the best cookies I've smoked. Best flavor, most smooth, so.
That's a pretty big compliment,
yeah,
dude.
Yeah,
I gotta tell you.
I smoked quite a few different.
She said that off cam, so I had to turn the cam on so you can hear it. So okay. Now she's gonna try the
Tahoe G. There we go. Sour flavor.
You like that one, huh?
I like it. It's good.
Far out.
Good job, Rosie.
Good job, Rosie. So my question now is, are you getting high from smoking all the, because you know you're smoking. This is something we noticed. When you smoke the same pot all the time,
you build up a tolerance.
Even if it's fucking 27% THC and 5% CBD,
your body becomes accustomed to it.
You become accustomed to it. And then, you know, in my day, I've even had some kind bud and like had somebody bring me some like B grade.
Yeah.
And I just smoked it and I got fucking high.
That's
because it's a different THC profile.
Absolutely. Right.
And that's what I was asking. So she smoked two completely different kinds of pot than she's used to smoking. Because right now she's smoking my Time Wreck.
Right.
And my Vortex.
I like Time Wreck a lot.
Yeah. But she likes Time Wreck.
My favorite.
Anyway. Now, to add to that,
and this Tahoe OG is breaking things up for me a little bit.
I've been smoking the Time Wreck during the day.
Yeah.
And then I tried the Jack the Ripper, one hit of it, and I completely forgot what I was doing.
I know. I told you.
Where the Time Wreck is, you can focus.
You can focus.
Your day.
Yeah. I find the hash the same way.
I have to say, I like the aftertaste of this.
Really?
Tahoe OG. It's got a real sweet.
It's a Tokyo OG.
Tokyo, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Tokyo OG. It's okay.
It's got a really sweet aftertaste.
Milk it, baby. Smoking out of the 50 millimeter Chaos bong. I bought that because I got tired of breaking bongs. This can also be doubled as a weapon.
Oh yeah.
I don't think you could break it. Look at the
no
base
way,
on it.
Dude.
Look at the base on it.
I know. Look at that base.
That's why I bought it. I was like, fuck, I'm tired of breaking this shit. You can't put ice cubes in it, it's so thick.
I like this one.
Yeah, no, that's not gonna break when it tips. This is gonna break when it tips.
Yeah, the bowl. That's what we figured.
And then the bong. A $15 bowl than a $400
bowl. You got it, dude. Okay, TC's up next. Nice, courteous Miss Jill to blow the ghost out.
All right, Tokyo OG.
By the way, TC Curtis is now a famous author. He has his very own article printed. Words and pictures by TC.
Now, mind you, it's like Team Green Avengers. It's a team effort, prospect, sub, you know.
Yeah, but you got the byline, baby. That's what it's all about.
Thank you.
You're welcome, man.
All right, we'll try some of this Tokyo.
And we don't usually do smoke sessions on the show, but we thought we'd do something new.
It does have a nice aftertaste. Very smooth for hydro. Thumbs up.
I forget you guys are smoking hydro.
Yeah, I know. I'm usually a big soil guy, so.
So whoever the grower is?
Mad props.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, back to work, people.
Back to work. See you guys.
See you.
fans, it's just, I don't know, man. Guys, if you like this as much as me, moose in Vermont leads cops to a grow operation. A moose rummaging way through a Burlington, Vermont neighborhood is apparently enough reason for police to search private property without a warrant. At least that's the precedent set over the weekend. Burlington police called to help out Vermont fish and game wardens in the area who are tracking down a moose wandering through a residential neighborhood. While searching out for the massive moose, apparently made their way onto people's private property, which came upon 32 pot plants. I can tell you my lawyer would have that case thrown out of fucking court. So, lawyer up, baby. I think that's about the news for today. There's not really a lot of interesting happening here. So. One more Jimmy. Do a little surfing here for you guys. Sheila, it's the time rack. Subby and a prospect been talking for days about harvesting this girl, but she's not quite ready just yet. Very, very soon, there's just so much weight on this plant, we want to make sure she's ready. Of course, we've got the beefy OVs, there's that big cola that defies imagination. It's probably a 3 or 4 ounce cola dry. Everything's looking really good in here. And there's the tiny. And this room's gonna be shut tomorrow all day long. It'll be waterproof, shut, duct tape, completely sealed up. These fans will all be shut off. These fans will be cut down. These fans on the floor, they'll be cut off. All air circulation will be cut off. And then we're gonna clean the big main breeding room. There's one thing they wanna do really bad, is get in here and do some cleaning. We wanna clean the hoods, we wanna clean the air conditioner, the dehumidifier, even maybe do a little bit of fan work. Can't do any of that stuff with all these big girls in here. So it's time to get them out. So with my pretty much daily report now from Subby's Grow Room, this is the Cannabis Hunter signing off. Everything that you were dreaming of.
doing a little reviewing of Steve Martin and Edie Brickell. Yeah, no shit. You never know what you're going to hear on this fucking show. So, whatever. Vortex number 5. Vortex number 4. Bigger, chunkier buds. Bellaborn lemon smell. Very nice. Okay, this is Three Bears by Jimi Hendrix. And fittingly, this is the story of the Three Bears. So Dioxide, Dirk Diggler, and Obie Diesel got together, trying to decide on how we were going to work on the new packs. And while Dirk Diggler has huge respect for Odie Diesel, and Odie Diesel has huge respect for Dirk Diggler, they could not come to terms or agreement on what a pack would look like that would encompass both of their themes, beliefs, and breeding backgrounds. So we're going to have two new lines. We're going to have Odie Diesel, which will be marketed under his line. Odie Diesel has already won 2 cups in Oregon. I would say that's pretty substantial resume. Dirk Diggler, as we well know, has 18 years in the hydro industry and the mist, and is basically who I consider the Bill Nye of the cannabis industry. They have very different lines, very different strains, and so the easiest thing for us to do was to just create 2 different lines. So you'll get TGA Presents Odie Diesel and TGA Presents Dirk Diggler. All this will be available at San Francisco Cannabis Cup. Little stuff that they have tested and proven. So you diehard fans are looking for these strains you keep hearing about and you're wondering where they're at. If they've made it their way through testing, you'll be able to find them in San Francisco. That's pretty simple stuff, and that's what I wanted to tell you about. I've been told by TGA that all the packaging, new packaging, will be ready. And we're damned excited about it. Some of the new strains, like the Mickey Kush, Pennywise, just amazing results we're getting. But the breeding, the testing, smoking, the enjoying, the medicating, it's all definitely moved ahead faster than the packaging and the marketing. And one reason is because, you know, a lot of companies, that's their thing, you know. One of my big competitors now, you know, they're in an ad that's touting packaging. Fucking packaging don't undergo shit, dude. You're gonna spend $4 or $5 on a pack so it looks good. And I guess it'll sell and everything. TGA's always built his reputation on one thing. Good genetics. What's inside the pack? Not a pack. What's that movie where that guy says, what's he say, he says, I could take a shit in a box and put a warranty on it, but it's still a piece of shit, right? Now this toke right here is in honor of Miss Jill.
Angel come down from heaven yesterday. She stayed with me just long enough for afternoon tea. And she tell me a story yesterday about the loop.
Well, I better go answer some emails. And the deep blue sea. I know I've got the nerds, the guys that make the cool glass. I'm going to probably go film them down in Vallejo, and we're pretty excited about that. And I know I've got a bunch of TGA email answer, and then we'll show you guys a bunch in the garden, and hopefully you guys will learn something, and hopefully this hasn't become too boring or repetitive. And if it is, you guys let me know, okay? I'm stuck in phone, by the way. This Hell's OG will go in about a day or two. I really want him to be ready though.
Look how sturdy those plants are. See how non-wimpy they are? It's because we've been in there working on them. Hey, this is important. A lot of times if you forget to untie the plant, you'll tear it. And sometimes you gotta let them go. Settle down a little bit. It'll reminds me of take a second to kind of just work its way down. You can see the tension kind of working its way down through all that yummy cannabis just not done, I'm late, bubbling.
It's just one of those bad days. Look outside and be careful what you ride. You just might
the heat will help it settle. See it slowly settling?
That you're out of time.
Then it goes down a little bit, fill it back up. So go to the sick and needy. That's how we roll. I just want to do a shout out to Coma Grow. I know you still watch the channel. Well, I think you do. I don't watch yours. The reason we have never gotten together is just, I'm so fucking busy. I mean, dude, I would love to hook up with you.
work together, all that stuff. But man, I'm so busy. I barely have time to even take care of my, you know, own family and my own business and everything. But I wanted to give you a personal shout out for the second time. I think you're a really cool guy, and I think you have a really amazing passion for growing weed. And I just want to let you know, I still know you're out there, bro. I'm just too busy to get sick going with you. And that applies to a lot of people out there in the world. Shout out to Come Grow. Thank you, Come.
Jokes thinks he's going to get a ride on Prospect. He's got everything ready. He's got his Tyvek suit on. He's got everything wet down. And he's going into the pollen room to clean up all our breeding mess. So we're going to let him have at it. Take care, bud.
Doesn't that look good?
But it's 3 p.m. time to let the game.
Kona Peaberry. A little splash of whipped cream. Miss Jill got me this caramel topping. I'm dying to try it. It's my baby bear. We'll see what we see today. Gotta get started.
It's been a while since we've had drive cam. So, Toke said he wanted to come down this morning and go take a look at the garden. We got a water leak down here. The guys are coming to fix. Bumps, that's just how things roll. So let's go see what's going on down here. Looks nice. Oh yeah. Got Prospect to come down here and set up all the girls for us. Up off the ground, of course. So no slugs or anything can get to them, but nice up in the wind. Fantastic. We're headed down to the garden. The lovely Miss Jill has prepared lunch for our workers. So, Coastal's finally figured out this thing. Pretty much the guys I hired are fucking retarded. I would say their name, but whatever. Live and learn. But this is zone 2. And so in order to keep the pressure equal, I really love this idea. He's going to do a loop, and the loop's going to go all the way down, all the way around, and come back and tee in. That way we'll maintain a constant pressure throughout the whole manifold. Let's go check out our plants. Toke, come. Toke is trying to mug their food. We have determined that this is most likely a male. He'll be killed shortly. And we have now finally started for the first time in history. Femming. Fuck, I missed. Actually, Coastal did that one for me. Jilly's really good at it. Crop's looking fantastic. Toke's looking hot. We'll go get him some cool water. There's plenty around, but he has a special spigot he likes. Everything's looking phenomenal. Here's really what I wanted to show you. We always had a problem with remember the little water hose thing down there? We had to button it up, everything was pulling. You reach down there and get a snake. Check it out. These are 4 foot high, loaded. And as soon as you turn the zone on, we have water. Pretty simple stuff. So now we have plenty of water in the garden. And we have zone 1, zone 2, and then the zones go right on up. I'm thinking maybe some type of like fruit tree or something right there. And then on up there, we'll do another tree, shrubbery, something like that. So there's the progress so far. I'd like to thank Prospect and Coastal. It's fucking hot as shit out here. The heat came on quick. It's probably 95 out here. And the dirt's hard as a rock. So I really appreciate it. I'd like to give a shout out. Willie Nelson, one of our most staunch advocates. He turned 80. Sweet. This life edition is dedicated entirely to him. So I would recommend that everybody go out and grab this and sit down and read it, because it is pretty fucking amazing. Pictures. Look at the car.
Was heavy as night. Don't cross it, don't boss it. He's wild in his sorrow. He's riding, hiding his pain. Don't fight, don't spite. Just wait till tomorrow. Maybe he'll ride on.
Fucking Tom Petty, Bob Dylan. Come on, guys. What do you want? Anyway.
Watched as he passed.
I hope Willie has a lot more in him than just one more.
She drew back in fear at the sight of
American hero. Looks like I got a little bit of work to do, huh? Yeah.
I challenge a new generation of young Americans.
Okay. Let's get it on. Let's go check out the Bud Room. I know I'm not supposed to be doing the music thing, but you know, sometimes I just have to, guys. Okay, let's step on in here. I'll kill this fan so I can talk. The main thing I wanted to show you, and I had a couple things to talk about soil, so I thought, well, I know it's the best place to talk about. I asked about the biggest bud you can get. When you consider that all these other buds are coming off of here. And that little bitty 7 gallon pot. And this is the time rack. It's coming down very, very soon. The chunkier plants I've seen. It's a beautiful garden. Well, I want to talk about super soil for just a second while I'm in the bud room. I've been catching a lot of traffic and thought it might be best to just explain what's going on. Everybody wants super soil throughout the whole country. You can only buy the bags of super soil in Washington and Oregon. They are working on getting into other states. It's the states that are preventing it. That's number one. Number two, TGA Super Soil offers a charge pack that you can order anywhere in the United States. It's $80 for the charge pack and $20 for the shipping. It's enough soil, it's enough ingredients to make enough soil to fill this entire room with plants. It costs us about $30 per pot to produce 10 ounces of quality organic marijuana, as close as you can get to organic as possible. I do not own the soil company. I do not ship the soil. If you are sending me emails, they are going to a dead end. If you are posting questions for TGA Super Soil on Roll It Up or YouTube, you're not getting answers because those people are busy mixing soil, buying pallets, buying scale fucking to weigh the pallets, because if the pallets over 3 ounces, they get charged an extra $20. And believe it or not, there's not that much profit on the soil anyway. So I am so happy everybody is excited about the super soil. You guys are more than welcome to simply mix it up. Or you can do like I've done, or a lot of growers have done all the way across America. Then just order a fucking pallet. Come on, man, 60 bags. I got one coming right now. I got 35 bags of base and 25 bags of super soil. You know, I'm probably gonna sell some people. Well, I'm pretty good at that.
you know, ordering soil's kicking your ass. Growing pot's gonna fuck your world up. Just like the people that came all the way to the Medical Cannabis Cup. I did get it, I'm really sorry about it, but you guys saw the dude from Miami, Florida standing in front of my booth, so where there's a will, there's a way. Let's go check out the other room. I guess it's about time to put the Hell's OG into the bud room. I gotta tell you something too. This flexible core prospect went and got on his own. This son of a bitch is a lifesaver. If you got a hard, rigid cord in your room, dump that motherfucker right away and get one of these. I twisted her up, but this is the shiznit. Doesn't tangle and works very well in your grow room. Well, if I didn't give you guys a bedroom update, you would give me shit. So, there's all our time wrecks, looking fucking phenomenal. Next crop, as you can see, not quite so harsh on the main lining. And we're starting to get the actual bushes that I like to see. For garden shots. Hopefully next week we're going on the road to go check out a glass blowing company down in Vallejo, California. The Nerds. Peace out, guys. I'd like to thank everybody for watching the show as always. I'm going to end the show with a little different tone tonight. Usually go out rocking and headbanging, but Miss Jill's out on a little back area, and we're gonna go out with a tote. So y'all know the drill here, right? Everybody get their implements of destruction, and let's have a tote. I want to give a shout out to Elby's Edibles, Hovering. You guys rock. Y'all make great stuff.
Amazing.
And you make great milkshakes.
We hope to see you at the San Francisco High Times Cup, entering those amazing milkshakes of yours. We know you can win.
Now here's the surprise. I was told today by TGA that we will be entering strains in the San Francisco Cup. So look forward to those announcements. Let's go out. Gotta love that headband. Have a dank day.